Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. I'm stuck at home, just like many of us, due to the virus. I know this is a very difficult time. I hope everyone is doing great. And I think that crafts is going to be a big help on these difficult times. So today I have the new Spellbinders card kit. Let's take a look on what's included and then I'm going to share three cards using products from this kit. Just like always, it's another adorable card kit. It's all about spring and Easter. There is a leaflet, just like always, with some ideas and how you can put a couple of cards together. And just like in every kit, every month, you will get 10 envelopes as well as 10 cards, pre-folded ones. You will get double-sided tape adhesive as well as foam squares. And let's take a look at the dies that you get for this month. Now these are adorable and I will be using them for one of my cards today. So you get an oval that can be an Easter egg as well. You get lots of foliage, leaves, flowers and little words that you can put your sentiment together. And I absolutely love those bunny ears. You can put them on top of this Easter egg or you can use lots of other creative ways to use them. Now this is the stamp set. It's all about Easter with bunnies and bows and little eggs. This is a set of gems with lots of glitter on top of them in four different colors. And just like always, you get a pack of stickers. The first page is puffy, dimensional, and you get two more pages with lots of different sentiments as well as other design elements. This is the paper pad for this month. Just like always, you get 20 different designs, two pages for each design. So that's a total of 40 pages. Some of them have some foiling, gold foiling on top of them. Really gorgeous, this one for example. And everything is coordinating with the stickers and the cardstock. Now let's take a look at the cardstock that you get this month. So 9 different pages of cardstock and one of them is a golden one. Now I'm going to put everything back into the box and I'm going to bring in all the die cuts. This is my favorite part of the card kit every month, taking a look on what's included here. You always get two pieces from each design. I like to lay them all over the place so that I can see what I get. And I always make areas like here. I have all the sentiments. I have the eggs over here, the bunnies or the butterflies in another area. And this makes my job easy so that I can easily pick up things that go together to create clusters for my cards. And let's start with the first card for today. For that I chose some of the eggs along with this banner and a basket. For my background I'm going to use this pattern paper, which I'm going to cut it to be slightly smaller than the standard card. And it's time to put my card together. I'm going to glue this on my card base. And I'm working on a white card base that was included in the kit. Now I usually share 10 cards when I'm working with this kit, but this is a pre-filmed video and it was back in the day when I was packing my whole craft room. I was super busy as we moved to our new house. I am doing the voiceover from my new craft room. It's a complete mess full of packages that I need to open up and set up. But to tell you the truth, it's not that bad because it gives me something to do now that we have to stay at home. So as you can see, I added foam squares at the back of my basket to pop it on my card. Now I'm going to place the sentiment underneath, and this is one of the die cuts that says Happy Easter, and I love the gold foiling on top of it. And then all I have to do is to tuck all those eggs inside the basket. Some of them are going flat directly at the background with glue, and a couple of them are going to be popped on top of them just for some dimension. For some of the eggs, I'm chopping a part of them so that I can easily tuck them inside the basket. And the card is looking beautiful, but I'm going to embellish it a little bit more with a couple of dies from the kit. So I cut out those tiny little leaves and those tiny little flowers, and I'm just going to stick them there. And in the kit, we do have those self-adhesive gems. So I'm going to use one of them at the center of my biggest flower, just to embellish it a little bit more, and I'm going to call this card done. You can see here some close-up photos, and I absolutely love those tiny little dies that cut out the leaves and the flowers. I think that they are so versatile and they can embellish every card. Now for the next card, I picked those flowers as well as some leaves and a sentiment with foiling. All of these have some gold foiling as a detail, so I think that they match beautifully together. I am going to cut out a panel out of this pattern paper so that I can create a background for my card. I always like to cut those panels slightly smaller than the standard card. It gives me a white border that finishes my card beautifully. I think it gives a really lovely detail. Now all I have to do is to play around with the leaves and the flowers to try and decide which is going to be my final arrangement. For some of the elements, just like always, I use glue to stick them flat on my card, and for others I'm using the foam squares at the back to add the dimension. Now this can be a very versatile card. Any sentiment would work with flowers. I'm also going to tuck underneath the leaves that I picked up. Now notice that these leaves are off-white, so if I was using a white background, they wouldn't stand out. So I pick every color carefully to help my composition stand out and look even more striking. Now all I have to do is to stick the sentiment. And this is one from the kit. I don't like how it has a white border all around, so all I have to do is to just cut it out. I'm using my scissors to fuzzy cut it, then I'm going to use a tiny little piece of foam tape at the back and stick it down. Now of course you can embellish your card as much as you like by using the gems included in the kit. I went with the pale ones and I'm going to stick some of them here and there. I absolutely love these gems because they are so unique. They have gold glitter on top of them. And here are some close-up photos of my finished card. Now for the last card for today, I'm going to play with the dies that are included in the kit. I absolutely love them, they are super adorable. I'm going to cut out the frame using gold cardstock, the leaves using a green one. The bunny ears have two parts, so I cut out the white and the pink one. And I also have the inside for my frame, which is going to be pink. It's exactly the same cardstock as the inside of the ears. And I also cut out the tiny little flowers that I used on the previous card out of white cardstock. Now this is a great way to use your scraps. And that's exactly what I did here. So I'm putting together this focal point, which is going to be super adorable. This can easily be turned into a shaker card, but I'm just going for an egg fun element for the top of my card. At the back of the ears, I'm adding double-sided tape, so at the front it's kind of sticky. I can pop inside those two pieces for my ears. And I'm going to use this pattern paper that has all that gold foiling at the background. Very subtle, but at the same it gives a beautiful shine. And I do have some gold on my egg on the outside frame, so I think it matches perfectly. Now I'm going to stick that down and then stick the frame all around. And you will see that I'm making a mistake here, but I'm going to let you see what I did and how I fixed it. I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back of my frame, and I do have foam squares at the back of the bunny ears so that they stick a little bit and add some dimension. And then I'm going to stick down the tiny little flowers that I have cut out. Just spread them around. You can really use any color for your flowers. I like how white stands out against my background here. And I don't like to use too many colors on a card as it makes it super busy. So I like to keep it simple with three or four colors at the most. At the center, I'm adding some Nouveau drops. This is yellow. And I am going to mat this panel with gold cardstock at the background. So you see I have a gold frame all around. And this is where I realized my mistake. The plan from the beginning was to emboss the sentiment at the center of my egg. But now after adding all of these things on top of the egg, it is practically impossible. So I just made another pink egg where I embossed my sentiment. I am adding glue at the back and I'm going to tag it inside, covering up the previous pink egg. So now I have a sentiment. Another way to go would be to use a stamping platform and just stamp the sentiment at the center of the egg. And another way to go would be to use one of the sentiment banners or the stickers from the kit and just stick it at the center of the egg. So here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. The kit, just like always, is super adorable. Here are a quick look on all the three cards that I made. I highly recommend the Spellbinders card kits. They are going to keep you busy now that you have to stay at home. Thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope that you had fun and that you got inspired. Keep on crafting and stay safe.